Spider-Man and His Amazing Friends, The Hulk. It seems like a playground to any comic book lover. Can you tell us a bit about those experiences working with such iconic characters?
Yeah, that was a blast for me. Again, Will Mineo was over there and Larry Houston came in, another friend of mine. And we were all avid fans of comic books, specifically Marvel comics. And with Stan there, it was just a wonderful moment for us. And we were the ones who really, because they had already started doing Spider-Man, just an animated series that was to be syndicated. And it's available, I believe, on Disney Plus now. And it's actually a pretty good series. It's fairly faithful to the characters because Stan really wanted something like that. He was looking to get these characters more popularized. So he wanted to make it a more serious approach. But NBC came to Marvel and said, look, we'd like something to counter ABC's Super Friends. And we'd like to do a Spider Friends show with Spider-Man. Because Spider-Man at that point had already had a series on, I think it was CBS, and had a live action series, and it had had a one Saturday morning show in the late 60s, Ralph Bakshi did. So they wanted to do a Spider-Friend series, combining some superheroes with Spider-Man. And initially, those were to be the Human Torch and Iceman to do a fire and ice thing. But they quickly realized they weren't going to use the Human Torch because, of course, children would immolate themselves to imitate the Human Torch, which everybody knows is ridiculous, but this was the thinking standards and practices at the time. So I got the opportunity with John Romita to create Firestar, and John came up with an initial design of the girl, which was, of course, gorgeous because that's what John Romita does. And he just did a wonderful body shape that I was able to work over, and I created a very simple costume for it and stylized the hair to look like flames. And that became the trio. And from there, Will and Larry and I became real acorns in the shoe to everybody in the studio to bring in more superheroes from the Marvel Universe. So that's why you begin to see Doctor Strange and Captain America and all these other superheroes appear at the show. And the ones we really kept telling them you got to do is the X-Men, because this is going to be huge someday. We all felt it was just great for what it was, because we all understood that it was about kids who were rejected in society, which every teenager feels at some time, and finding a place to utilize their skills. And of course, that's what the X-Men is all about. It's about people who are rejected by society and finding a place to use their skills to become helpful to the world, even if the world still can't accept them. But that's just a great concept, and the characters were wonderful. So by the end of the first season, we got an episode in there where Firestar, it turns out, had been one of the X-Men, which Marvel sooner or later made a reality within the comics icon. So we had a great time working on the show. The second season was even more fun. The only fun that wasn't involved was Firestar was really sexy in the first season.
I was going to go there.
And then NBC comes along and says, standards and practices like you to take your breast size down and take a little bit off that the crack in her butt, please. So I did that, and by the third season, she had really tiny breasts and virtually no indication that there was, anything other than a rear end there on the back.
Firestar was too hot.
Yeah, it was too hot for little girls and boys, But everybody loves the character. It has stood the test of time. And along the way, they sold the Hulk to NBC, so we did an hour show with Spider-Man and the Incredible Hulk. Of course, they changed things from the originals, but they still had all the original characters there, but they had to make Rick Jones into a long hair country boy, and that's okay. He was still Rick Jones. And other than that, most everybody stayed very similar to the comics, and we brought in a lot of the characters from the comics and that.